Welcome back, all the students and watchers. Today, in this video lecture, we are going to discuss on Hopf's transformation method for the structural members, cones. So, as of so far, we have discussed the problem on process. For that, the procedure was same. So, when we are talking about flexibility matrix method, the overall procedure, whatever you are using, so far will remain same, except few changes in your formulas. Okay, so these 11 steps, all the formulas, you have to keep it in your mind, same as it is. There will be no changes. So today we are going to discuss on frame, and I will be discussing here a problem on bent frame. So this is an example of a bent frame. This kind of problem I'm going to explain today. So let's see what formula we have to use for. To determine static intermittency, you need to use Ds equals to R minus P formula. And then for the flexibility matrix, here for the frames, again we should go with moment concept or static hopping concept. Today, the first problem I will be discussing by using moment concept on bent frame. I hope it's clear. Rest of all the steps and formulas remain same as it is with the continuous beam problems. So directly I will move on to the problem. We'll see one problem. So here there is one bent frame is given. You need to analyze this bent frame by flexibility method. Okay, so external loads, one point load and another one is UDL is given. R1 and R2 initially it will not be there. I have written over here. Don't get confused. R1 and R2 will not be there in your question. I have written while solving the problem. So as per your first step, find out static indeterminacy, that's R minus E. So count the reaction. This side is spin support is given. So 2 will be the reaction, and this side fixed support is given, so reaction number of reactions will be 3, so total 5. Always remember one thing: you should never neglect horizontal forces in by doing the calculation of frames, because horizontal forces will play a major role. Like it will only give a clarity for us between sway and non-sway frames. You cannot neglect horizontal forces. In case of continuous beams, you have a choice. You can keep or you can remove, because it won't be affecting much the continuous beams. But here it is not the condition. So equilibrium equation also I have kept it as 3. Horizontal, vertical as well as moment. So my answer is 2. By removing all the external loads, I have written a free body diagram over here, if you can see. So this one, since I got static intermittency as 2, I'm going to release this hinge support. In order to get one determinate structure, I'm going to release this hinge support over here. To release this hinge support, that means two reactions I have to release, one vertical, one horizontal I have released, okay? Corresponding to this, you have to write Q forces, nothing but local forces. See, by writing Q forces, always keep one thing in your mind, that every free joint will carry three forces, horizontal, vertical, as well as moment. Every free joint in a frame, it will carry three forces. If you have any force opposite to this or to balance the load, then you can cancel anyone. See, fixed support, there is no Q only. Why? Because it's already rigid. It is having one horizontal, one vertical, as well as moment. So all three will just cancel each other. You need not write any. It's already rigid. What about this? This one. This is a piece of joint. Because we have released R1 and R2, no, nothing is there here. So, it's a free joint. I'm going to write all three over here. So, I've written Q1, Q2, and Q3. What about this edge? Look at this edge. This is a vertical member. already one edge is rigidly supported. So even if I'm going to write vertical force over here, what happens? This downward vertical force will counterbalance. So you should not write any vertical force over here, true force. But your horizontal force will come into act. But this Q2 is passing all over this AB member, right? The same amount of Q2 will pass through your joint B also. No need to be one more extra node, or you should not keep it as a separate Q force. Got it? So this side is a free joint. So I'm writing all three forces here. And this joint B, vertically it is rigid. So no need to write. It is not going any deformation in a vertical direction. But horizontal force, whatever is passing through this joint, will also pass through the joint B. So that continuation I have shown here. This is a moment horizontally, this joint is horizontally carrying a force of Q2. Vertically it's all already fixed it is. So only left thing is moment. That moment I have marked here. So this is how you need to mark two forces for the bent frame. So in the next step, find out second step, flexibility matrix. As I said, here I have used moment concept, clockwise, anti-clockwise concept. So your formula will be L by 6EI, 2 minus 1 minus 1, 2. If EI value is separate, you have to substitute that also. Here both the member carrying same moment of inertia, so no problem. So find out AB and BC. This is unassembled. Assemble it by placing all the whatever the values you found out, place them in a diagonal position, so other elements will be zero. So these two are zero. So in the third step, what you have to do, you need to find out fixed end moments and shear forces. So here I have separated AB and BC span. As per the formula, you have to go with this. So this side A and B. So this side formula will be WAB square by L square. You keep it in that mind. Or else in the procedure I have attached with this. See, this is a free bending moment. Yeah, here it is. So MFAB and MFBA formula, third one. It's available here. I have used this formula to find the moment over here. So find out the moment. And then this is WL square by 12. So since the load is going from right to left direction, the moment I have marked like this. Don't get confused. Okay. So all the moments and support reactions, you have to do the calibration. Formulas I have written at the bottom. You can see here. WL square by 12 for the UDL. Both the ends it will carry same load. So I return minus MFTG over here. So find out the support reaction by using summation B and summation M condition. It will be over. So substitute all the values, whatever you have found out here. Just reverse the directions of the all the values. You will be getting your equivalent joint load diagram. So based on this equivalent joint load diagram, I will be writing this two values. So this first one is Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, like that I have written. So let's see where is Q1. So Q1 is in vertically downward direction. So this Q4 diagram you have to match with your EQJL diagram. So this 37 is also in vertically downward direction. So there is no problem with this side. So I have written plus 37 only. If both are in the same direction, you should write positive. If your Q4 and your whatever the found out the forces are different in direction, then you have to reverse the sign. Is it clear? Here Q1 is also in downward direction, as well as your 30, this support reaction is also in downward direction. So I will write plus 37.03. So next, what is Q2? Q2 is a horizontal force. So horizontal force, if you see near joint A, you won't be getting any horizontal force. But the same horizontal force is passing through joint B also. Right? See here, the same Q2 force is passing through joint B also. So go to joint B and see whether any horizontal force is existing or not. See here, this 37.5 is there. This is a horizontal force. But your Q2 is going towards right, but the 37.5 is going towards left. So that's why your negative sign is given. It's not passing in the same direction of the Q force, whatever you have assumed. So reverse the direction and try down here. Is it clear? What about Q3? Q3 is near joint A. Assume direction is also in clockwise. And the 44.4 we got also in a clockwise direction. So I have written in positive. Then you see Q4 is near joint B. And near joint B, you have two moments. -22.22 and +31.25. This one is anti-clockwise and this one is in clockwise direction. So +31, -22, the answer you got it as 9.03. So this is how you need to find Q-force. To write the Q-force, you need you require two diagrams. One is Q-force diagram, another one is EQJL diagram. Is it clear? So next, I will move on to transformation matrix. So as of our steps, it's very clear for the transformation matrix. We will be getting two matrix. One is BR, another one is BQ. So put unit values for unknowns individually. Find out the moments. In the same way, put unit values for Q forces individually and find out what is the resultant moment. That will give you BR and BQ matrix. So look at over here. First, R1, I have put it as 1. Okay, this R1 is going to lift your beam in upper direction. That means joint A will be coming in clockwise direction. So to counterbalance these, rest of moments are given. Okay, we are having like this. So our unknown, this is our unknown R1. What it will do when you are going to apply the force R1, this R1 is going to lift your beam like this, right? So that means this one will rotate your beam in clockwise direction. So this side is rotating in a clockwise direction. Obviously, this edge should rotate in anti-clockwise direction. So to balance this joint, give moment in for the clockwise direction. Like this, you have to balance the moment. So this is your R1 and it's acting over here. So force is acting at joint A itself. So you will not be getting any moment. The moment over here it is 0, right? So as we know, I think AB distance is 6 meters, right? Yeah, AB, the span AB is 6 meters. So you will be getting. So we'll be getting, this is R1, we have taken it as a 1. So 1 into total 6. So I'll be getting this moment as 6 as well. So this side is also, I'm going to get 6 only. Right? So same distance. So obviously, near joint C also, we will be getting 6. The This is how you need to write down the transformation matrix. So look at R2 now. So R2 is in horizontal direction. So that means there is no perpendicular distance for joint B. So directly we will be getting moment as 0. And the span of BC number is 5 meters. So 1 into 5. Vertical distance is 5. So we will be getting 5. Is it okay? So Q1 and Q2 is same as R1 and R2 because directions are same. You see this too? Yeah. What about Q3? Q3 is a moment. Don't make it as 0 over here. Q3 itself is a moment. So rest of all the values, whatever you are going to get, will also be a moment. See now, okay. R1 and R2, I hope it's clear now. So Q1 and Q2 is also same. So Q3 is a moment. So this side is 1. So counterbalance the direction and all the moments will be getting it as 1 only. What about Q4? See, as I said, it's an element-based method. So Q3 will belongs to AB span. But here Q4 belongs to your BC span. So first element is separate and second element is separate. So whatever Q4 you are going to apply, you see it is applicable only for the BC span. Okay, so AB span will not carry any moments and the BC span will carry both the value as 1 and 1. So based on anti-clockwise, clockwise, positive and not, I have written the values. So starting from joint A and joint B, joint C, I have written all the values. So just see this. So rest of thing is a simple calculation. Always try to multiply BR transpose into F first. Because this term is going to repeat in your next step also. So you can directly take this value. So do the calculation. And one more thing, you need not to multiply this FRR inverse and FRQ always first. So you try like this, FRQ into Q, and then it will reduce to 2 cross 1. So directly you can multiply FRR inverse in your calculator. So try that method. First multiply FRQ into Q, and then multiply that term with FRR. So the top thing is a simple calculation. PEQJL, you are going to get it from EQJL diagram. So whatever the moment you got, based on that moment, I have written here, like clockwise, anti-clockwise and all. So do the calculation. We will discuss another problem. Like perfect frame will be discussed in the next video lecture. Thank you all.